launched a new album and are about to go on tour.
Their charismatic bass player, Jean-Jacques Burnel, has been with them since the start. In between the tours, he's at home in Cambridgeshire and has become the country's top teacher of a highly skilled form of karate.
This is the story of a poor man's son. He put himself up, turned his face to the sun.
Once famed for the wild antics which characterised many of the bands of the punk era, Jean-Jacques, or JJ, is now a married 40-something with children. He's tamed, well, just enough, and he says that could be largely thanks to the sport which has now become a major part of his life.
You'll sacrifice a lot of speed if you're very tense.
JJ set up a Shidokan karate club 5 years ago after returning from Japan, a sensei or teacher. Now, as a third dan, he's the highest ranking teacher in the country.
When we're on the road, then obviously I'm not here, and we have backup teachers. But it is a commitment, and it's a worthwhile commitment, especially when you see some of the kids go from white belt start here, and their movement is all over the place, and then a couple of years later their movement is much more fluid, and they've also gained something from it.
JJ and the band are now embarking on a European tour promoting their latest album, About Time. But who's in the audience nowadays?
Good question. There are people who were around 15 to 20 years ago, the punks of yesteryear, and some of them are bringing their kids along now, 8, 9-year-olds, but there's a whole new generation of audience, of people who are 15, 16, who, for one reason or another, have discovered the Stranglers for the first time, which is cool.
Punk never really was my scene, but they seem to have stood the test of time.
Yeah, Frank
Sinatra
fan, aren't you?
Rock and roll, really.
Now, Stuart, where are you off to on your sport?